of the Empire.
Didn't see that coming, huh?
Welcome, fellow Grandpa Head, Joe Pop Putty Man here. And today, we are doing the official review for Solo, A Star Wars Story. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and go in a particular order for this video when I do the review when it comes to the cast, the characters. Then at the end, we will do our spoiler review. So I will make sure to give you that warning. And I am especially hyped about this because of what happened in the movie. But we'll get to that later. So first off, let's talk about the cast. Now, who I was hoping to be the strong point in this movie, in my eyes, was exactly what I thought it would be. And I'll explain to that when we get to that point. First off, I want to go ahead and go through some characters. First and foremost, Alden Ehrenreich. I can never pronounce his name, that plays the young Han Solo. First and foremost, before we get into his character, I want to say this movie is a solid movie. There are plenty of surprises. It's a great movie. I can't say it's the best Star Wars movie I've seen, but I by far did enjoy it, especially a few of the cast in there that made it really enjoyable. First and foremost, let's go back to Han Solo. Now, he looks the part, and there are a few times I can see where they're going with the Han Solo, his posture, things of that nature. But I really feel like he struggled to play the character. I feel like he had trouble getting the essence of what Harrison Ford's character's Han Solo was. The wisecracking, some of that stuff didn't feel like it was there. But nonetheless, the supporting cast really brought things out of him to make things a little bit better. Especially one character, which we'll definitely get to later. Next one I want to speak about is Emilia Clarke as Kira. She actually plays the love interest for Han Solo in the movie. And, you know, based on her character, based on who she is, very good. And the reason I say very good is because there were a few things I didn't expect to happen that did happen, which did come to maybe a shock or maybe an awe. I don't know how to explain it without really spoiling anything, at the same time not giving it away. But she did a good job of her character. So again, she plays the love interest to Han Solo. Next, we have Beckett, played by Woody Harrelson. Now, this role right here, I feel like it was made for Woody Harrelson, to be very honest with you. It felt like a Woody Harrelson role. And it was quite possibly a really good role. Basically, he ends up in the Empire with Han Solo, and they end up meeting through there. And, you know, he perfectly set off his role perfectly to where, you know, you love him, but you also hate him. I don't know how to explain it. You'll understand when you see the movie without spoiling too much into that. And then, of course, we do have Phoebe Waller-Bridge that plays the character of L337, which is a droid for the next character I'm going to get into. She is the co-pilot of the Millennium Falcon. And yes, I am saying she is a female droid. And quite possibly, the droids they're making in these movies from Rogue One to all this are very enjoyable characters. I feel like the droids have way more personality outside of one other cast member in this movie, which we'll be getting to soon. Now let's get into our favorite little furry pal, Chewbacca, played by Junis Sotamo. Now, I know I'm probably mispronouncing that, but he did a great job of that role. But of course, you don't really have to do much when it comes to playing Chewbacca, except for have the posture and the way he acts, the lovableness of him. And he does it. I feel that since he's taken on the role of Chewbacca, since I can't think of his name, since what's his name, that can't take on the role because of his body being injured or being weak, that he's done a good job taking over for Chewbacca. He's done a phenomenal job of it. And he did a great job in this. It felt like Chewbacca. Honestly, the Chewbacca was better than the Han Solo in my eyes. So you're going to love Chewbacca in this. You're going to love his little mannerisms, everything. It's Chewbacca. He does a great job. Then finally, the one you guys are probably all, you saw it in the crawl in the beginning. I love his music. I love his movies. I love his shows. Ladies and gentlemen, Donald Glover and Lando Calrissian. My God, he is Lando Calrissian, just like Ryan Reynolds as Deadpool. He pulled this off so well. His charisma, the way he acted, everything that came down to it was just such a beautiful thing. And And what I mean by that is, like, the way he would have thrown his charisma, but you know he's a little sneaky with what he's doing, and he's all about himself. This is what Lando Calrissian is. But what makes it so great is not even just how he acts it, it's just very little subtle things he does that makes me think of Lando Calrissian. Again, I feel like Donald Glover was made to play the younger Lando Calrissian. Like, he was made for this role. And honestly, his scenes always made me excited to find out what's going to happen or laugh or anything of that nature. He really did a phenomenal job of that character. So what did I think overall? Now, again, we do have other characters that I'm not going to get into, not because I don't like the characters, but because I wanted to get into more of the major characters, and these are our kind of side characters, and again, that's something that you would have to see for yourself to see what I'm talking about. Now, before I get into the spoiler part, I'm going to go ahead and tell you what I feel. Here's the thing. I'm not saying this is a bad movie, but I'm also not saying this is the greatest movie. Based on me seeing Infinity War, Deadpool 2, those two actually are still better than this. Now, of course, this is way better than Rampage or any of these other movies you can see. It is definitely worth your box office ticket to go see it. Especially if you're a Star Wars fan. You want to see this movie if you're a Star Wars fan. Straight up beyond. If you've seen the original trilogy, go and see this movie. If you've even seen the prequels, go and see this movie. And that's where I'm going to actually get into the spoilers. Yes. So here is your spoiler advisory right now. We're going to go into spoilers right as we speak. So if you have not seen the movie, stop here. The review is done. Go away. I'm going into spoiler territory. You need to leave now. Oh, you guys gone yet? Okay, awesome. So, the references to so many things. First off, the Kessel Run. The Kessel Run is in the movie. The Kessel Run is in the movie. He finally did the Kessel Run. We have the meeting of him and Chewbacca, which was just so magical because they were forced to be together, and it ended up making probably the closest relationship in the whole movie. It was so breathtaking. That's the one thing I will say. When he was with Chewbacca, he did a great job of taking that characteristic of loving Chewbacca, but I felt like there could have been a little more humor involved, because they have, and I guess maybe that's because there's time between them that gives them that time to become what they become later in the movies, so maybe that's the reason they did it. But now, Lando and Han's situation, oh my god, you have to agree, the chemistry, the way they talk to each other feels exactly like they have that friendship, but they love to hate each other, and that's what happened in the later movie, the original trilogy. They love to hate each other, but they still respect each other, except Lando always had something up his sleeve, literally, which if you see, well, of course, the spoiler, he literally has something up his sleeve, and that's what makes that really funny, but he pulled it off to a T. Now, here's where I want to get into it. First off, I'm glad he finally won they did the game where he won the Millennium Falcon. I love how they did the progress of showing Lando cheating and then trying to cheat, but Han did a little twist on him. But you're probably wondering one thing that if you're not a big fan, you probably don't realize. I'm going to explain this to you. At one point in the movie, if you remember, Kira backstabs Han Solo. And of course, she's the love interest, you don't expect it. And towards the end, you actually see her speak with a Sith Lord, so to speak. And that Sith Lord is, ladies and gentlemen, Darth Maul. No joke, Darth Maul is in this movie. Now, a lot of you are probably wondering, I thought Darth Maul died. Now, I'm going to show you some pictures. First off, if you've seen the Star Wars Rebels, you've seen that Darth Maul is alive. But one thing I didn't like about Rebels is they didn't show the mechanical legs. And you can clearly see in Solo the mechanical legs. But what this is actually referencing is actually an old comic. Back in the, I can't remember exactly when it came out. It was a while back. I think it was, I can't remember exactly when it was. But I think it was called Visions of Old Wounds or something of that nature. And that's basically where Darth Maul goes back to actually kill Luke, and Obi-Wan is actually there to protect him. This is like right before the original trilogy. And you actually see Darth Maul with very big spikes, as you can see in this picture, and robotic legs. What I think they did was they took the Rebels version and combined it with the version from the comic to give us a new origin of Darth Maul. So what am I expecting on this? Well, here's the thing. I think they're setting up. I think they are going to still continue with the Star Wars stories, and we're actually going to get our Obi-Wan story. And I think at one point we're actually going to have the fight at the end where Obi-Wan is protecting Luke and fights against Darth Maul. And it's going to be an epic battle. They want to make it great. I think that's why Darth Maul is back in this. They're setting up. So at the same time, his crown of spikes might be bigger by the time we get to Obi-Wan, because based on the way this movie is, we still have years till that happens, because Han Solo and Chewbacca need to set a relationship in this to continue themselves onwards with the relationship. So I think that's the reason why Darth Maul is, which makes me very happy, because a lot of people like to put off the prequels as bad movies. Yes, a few of them are bad. But my point to the whole thing is we had cool characters like Darth Maul, and I didn't want to see that die. And I'm so blessed to see that they're going to try to rekindle that, or at least showing a rekindlement within this movie. And it was so great. My eyes lit up when I saw him bring back the hood, and there's Darth Maul with his dual lightsaber and everything. It was amazing. Oh, it was amazing. So overall, like I said earlier, I love the movie. I'm definitely very excited for it, but I think they could have done a lot better. And I think it more comes down to Alden. Alden as Han Solo, I feel like he didn't bring it like I wanted him to, which he could have. But Donald Glover and the rest of the cast blew it out of the water. Great way. So there are some slow parts. There are some slowing down parts. But I want to know what you think. Comment below and tell me what you thought of Solo, A Star Wars Story. Do you feel it gave us everything we wanted for Han Solo? Because I still think that it did. And I think that we may have it intertwined with him and maybe Obi-Wan, or maybe something of that nature, or maybe never. We don't know. Because the thing is, they don't really meet until the first episode of, or I should say, episode 4, New Hope. So, but there you have it. There is my Solo, A Star Wars Story official review. I want to thank you all for watching. Make sure you hit that like button. Make sure you hit the subscribe button. And make sure you hit the little notification bell and become part of the notification squad. I don't know what I'm going to see next. I was thinking about seeing Incredibles, but financially, I might not be able to. I know I will be seeing Ant-Man and the Wasp, which I think comes out in July or August. So I'll definitely be getting my tickets for those. But we'll see what I do. I might not do a movie review next month, so I might have to give you guys some extra additional content. But if there's a particular movie you think I should go see, definitely tell me, and I'll look it up and see if it's something I'm interested in. But as always, I am Putty Man with Game of Hotheads. Do not forget, we're all about the high score. Peace out. I'll talk to y'all later.